Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. I'm Brian Walsh, Product Marketing Manager at Parallel Wireless. In today's video, I'll share more about our end-to-end Open RAN solution that enables mobile network operators to reimagine the networks and reduce their TCO, all while creating a seamless migration path to 5G. Let's get started. Let's talk about the 5G market first. The Global Mobile Suppliers Association estimates there are 176 operators in 72 countries that have launched one or more 3GPP compliant 5G services, and hundreds of other operators are investing in 5G network planning and trials. And the reach of 5G networks has expanded impressively. This chart from Analysys Mason shows that the percentage of population covered by 5G has increased remarkably over the past couple of years. For example, 5G coverage in the US has reached 93.1% in 2021, and South Korea reached 93.9%. While Europe has lagged in 5G reach, population coverage has almost doubled between 2020 and 2021, now reaching 62% of the population. And to date, most of the 5G networks launched have been based on non-standalone 5G cores. While 5G coverage is expanding and growing at a fast rate, the 5G subscriber base is still quite low, especially given the percentage of population reached by 5G networks. Operators deploying 5G services have also seen limited impact on ARPU. For example, GSMA Intelligent estimates that in some cases, mobile operators' ARPU drop due to increased uptake of discount plans, rising competition, and pressure to lower tariffs to attract new users to 5G network services. Other operators with 5G offers across all geographies have seen low or flat ARPU growth. One reason for the minimal impact of 5G ARPU is that operators deploying 5G services have launched offers focused on bandwidth speed and not based on differentiated services. Many of these 5G networks are using 5G non-standalone, or NSA, which relies on the 4G LTE network core. While this non-standalone approach has allowed mobile operators to get out the gate quickly with 5G services, it has limited the possibility of effectively deploying more advanced 5G services in order to drive new revenues. For example, although network slicing can be done on LTE and 5G non-standalone, for it to really work well, it requires a 5G core, which is what 5G standalone brings to the table. 5G promises much more than higher speed connections. We're all familiar with these commonly cited and promised 5G application opportunities shown here. For example, enhanced mobile broadband. That's an area where we will see a range of applications that currently are hampered by slow speeds. For example, we're starting to see MNO offers for fixed 5G wireless access to provide ultra-fast internet for consumers and businesses. Other higher bandwidth applications like 4K and in the future 8K streaming or even 360-degree video will enable high-quality immersive experiences at real-time speeds for consumers. Another area commonly cited is ultra-reliable low-latency communications. That's going to be one of the biggest game changers once 5G is fully deployed. We'll see new applications that require response time in fractions of a second. Examples here include autonomous vehicles, industrial automation applications that are not possible with current wireless technology. A third area targeted for 5G are massive machine-type communications, sometimes called massive IoT. This will include wearables, trackers, sensors, along with gadgets, appliances, and machines that we interact with on a daily basis that are or will be directly connected over a cellular connection. 5G will enable far more devices to operate seamlessly in any given area. Smart city services is another area where we will exploit the explosion of sensors and connected devices. And what these advanced 5G applications and services really require to work well is a 5G core, which is what 5G standalone or 5G SA brings to the table. And there are some real drivers for 5G SA to pick up momentum in 2022. Firstly, 5G standalone is required for advanced use cases such as network slicing, mobile edge computing, and ultra-reliable low-latency communications, and the demand for all of these advanced use cases is picking up. Secondly, 5G standalone momentum is now increasing in the market, with 19 operators worldwide introducing 5G SA services by the end of 2021, three of which are based in Europe. Thirdly, network slicing is gaining traction. Network slicing, which enables multiple virtual 5G networks to be created on top of one physical network, has been in the works for many years. And with 5G standalone networks launching, it's likely that we'll start seeing real network slicing deployments and offers. For example, Telia has deployed a commercial 5G standalone network in Finland, and the operator highlighted its ability to introduce networking slicing now. In addition, Rogers Communications in Canada has rolled out a nationwide 5G SA network and said that it was an important step towards new features such as network slicing and mobile edge computing. Also, new MNO offerings are being tied to service levels because 5G standalone enables a services-based architecture. This opens up the ability to slice the 5G network into customized virtual pieces that can be tailored to the needs of individual enterprises, all while maximizing the network's operational efficiency. Advanced cases for 5G NR aren't backward compatible with LTE infrastructure, so all operators are eventually going to need to get to 5G standalone. And to that end, we're seeing operators are developing per application services for enterprise industrial use cases. Another emerging development expected to accelerate 5G standalone is the emergence of mobile devices that will support advanced 5G features such as network slicing. In late 2021, Google released Android 12 iOS, which supports 5G enterprise network slicing. Android 12 iOS includes a dynamic policy control mechanism called the User Equipment Route Selection Policy, which enables devices to switch between different network slices depending upon what application they're using. For example, a worker could use one network slice to send highly sensitive information because that slice has special security, and another slice that has low latency to participate in a video call. Apple iPhones for 5G will roll out in earnest in 2022, and it's known that the company filed a patent application with the US Patent and Trademark Office detailing 5G network slicing support. So 5G standalone is going to unleash the potential not just for these differentiated services, but also for the operator to drive new 5G revenue and ARPU growth. Parallel Wireless has created the world's only 5G, 4G, 3G, and 2G Open RAN architecture that makes delivery of wireless coverage and capacity use cases affordable, including for 5G capital-intensive networks. The architecture illustrated here shows how Parallel Wireless is building our end-to-end solution architecture, all based on O-RAN standards. Our cloud-native, all-G Open RAN solution is software upgradable, thus reducing the cost and complexity of transitioning networks to 5G. We provide a variety of solution options spanning the complete end-to-end ecosystem, such as RU options with multiple radio hardware vendors that can interconnect with the Parallel Wireless DU and CU, or certified DUs and CUs from other vendors within the Open RAN ecosystem. And the Parallel Wireless 5G Open RAN solution supports versatile CU deployment modes, where the CU can be a centralized or distributed CU as required by different deployment use cases. With our 5G Open RAN solution, the network is simplified and has lower OpEx and CapEx. And our solution features an ecosystem of 5G radios complemented by next generation 5G core network solutions. Parallel Wireless's Open RAN capabilities are foundational elements for operators to offer scalable, service-centric 5G services. First and foremost is the Parallel Wireless Open RAN architecture we just discussed. It's a cloud-native solution that disaggregates RAN software and hardware and separates the control and data plane for RAN control functions. This will enable the elastic scalability and capacity needed to meet 5G's requirements for multi-gigabit data speeds, ultra-low latency services, massive network capacity, and a more uniform experience to more users. This modern 5G Open RAN architecture is also essential to enable new mobile operator 5G service revenues, such as RAN sharing, new network slicing applications that we discussed earlier. Secondly, 5G networks are expected to be 10 times denser than 4G networks and will be more complex and costly to operate. And as such, self-learning and self-optimizing capabilities found in the parallel wireless open RAN solution will be important to efficiently manage the network. Our advances in network automation of network tasks and zero-touch provisioning will simplify management and operation. Also, our O-RAN compliant architecture incorporates intelligent frameworks for machine learning, especially the RAN Intelligent Controller, also called the RIC, which provides programmatic control of the RAN. These RIC applications enable automatic execution of data-driven decision-making and machine learning models. Thirdly, Parallel Wireless has created the largest ecosystem of partners for Open RAN solutions across every aspect of the network, from radio to server to RAN Intelligent Controller to the mobile core and much more. We're fully committed to the diversified supply chain model, which is a key pillar of Open RAN. With interoperable hardware and software, mobile network operators are getting the most flexible, easily scalable, and cost-efficient 5G networks that enable state-of-the-art broadband communications. Lastly, our Open RAN solution is customer-centered by being future-proof. Parallel Wireless's O-RAN compliant CU and DU software support all radio access technologies, or RATs. And all of these RATs are software upgradable and can run concurrently on COTS hardware. You can pay as you grow with minimal to no hardware changes. No rip and replace, everything grows with you. And furthermore, our large base of Open RAN customers have experienced measurable benefits, including improved energy efficiencies, decreased implementation times, improvements in supply chain and equipment availability. For example, even with the recent pandemic supply chain disruptions, operators have been able to acquire standard COTS hardware from multiple sources of supply to continue their RAN modernization efforts. So, as operators move to 5G standalone in order to offer differentiated services, the Parallel Wireless 5G Open RAN solution will provide them new capabilities, markets, and revenue opportunities. Well, that's all for today's video. I hope it was helpful. If you'd like more information from Parallel Wireless, you can find us on LinkedIn, Twitter, and Facebook, as well as at our website at parallelwireless.com. As always, thanks for listening, and we hope to see you here again soon for our next video.